From Sydenham to South Africa, Italy, France, Spain, Argentina, Australia, taste the world with Stoles, sponsors of Holiday Showdown.
Coming up on Holiday Showdown, it's the normal versus the paranormal. Chillingham Castle, Northumbria, one of a terrifying list of locations on the Angel Guest family's ghost hunting holiday.
Our holiday is about finding haunted places. We're not the cereal packet family, never have been and probably never will be.
Haven Holiday Parks, favourite destination for over 2.5 million Britons every year, including the Palmer family.
Well, our holiday is all about having fun, basically, morning, noon and night.
Both families are up for a challenge.
We do ask you to respect ghosts and spirits because they do have feelings too.
I mean, if she wants a reaction from me, she'll get a reaction from me.
They've never met, but are convinced they can show the other family a fantastic time on their holiday.
I'm just not feeling anything at all.
I don't think as a sceptic, I think as scared.
Two very different families.
I don't really want Tracy in my aura.
I was out of order. Big talk.
Two very different holidays.
It's not my ideal of a holiday.
Holiday Showdown.
No, you're contradicting yourself. Now okay. you're saying the opposite. Well, which one is it?
It's a tourist attraction.
You brought them on this holiday.
High up in the Malvern Hills in Worcestershire is the haunt of the Angel Guests, a family of psychics. Mystic Julie and her partner Christian are both ordained reverends of the Universal Life Church. They never go away without Christian's daughter Emily and nephew Danny. Julie made the unusual career move from police officer to full-time psychic. And ex-roadie Christian shares her ability to commune with the dead as well as being a Reiki practitioner. Their favourite holiday is combining their ghost-busting work with a mystical tour of the most haunted spots in Britain.
Most of our holidays have involved doing ghost-busting and things involving the paranormal.
The holiday isn't an obvious choice for children, but they believe that contacting the dead can be fun for the whole family.
As a family, we believe that introducing our children into the spiritual dimension of life is an eye-opener. If someone were to say to us, don't you think you're scaring your children? Well, we don't bring them kicking and screaming into the car with us. They decide to come of their own free will.
The whole family are members of the same faith and each possess a different psychic ability. Emily is an apprentice herbalist, whilst Danny has just become an ordained reverend and fills his spare time drawing people's auras.
We see family orbs. We do tend to see gremlins, which are these ugly creatures here, and now which do actually look like the gremlins out of the Gremlins films and stuff out Ghostbusters and stuff. That's nearly all true, actually.
Borrowash in Derby is home to the Palmer family. Dad Bill is a gardener, Mum Tracy a beautician. They have 5 children. Amy 17, Jordan 15, Corey 12, Alice 11 and Amelia 7.
Most people call us the Palmer Army because there's so many of us.
The Palmers organise their holidays around the kids. They choose to go to Haven in Devon for its typical British mix of arcades, activities and audience participation.
When our final round holiday, it's all action-packed from the word go.
I couldn't go somewhere and the kids just sat there bored. I couldn't do that.
Bill is unaware that he'll be going on a psychic holiday, but it's likely to be a challenge, as the only spirits he chases are the ones in his local pub.
I'm an atheist through and through. Yeah. I don't believe in life after death, and I don't believe in praying. All these ghosts and ghoulies and all this, it's crap.
If any of the family were complete sceptics, I love sceptics. I'm 110% certain that I can convince them that there is something more to life than life itself.
I thought I was a big drinker. Christ almighty. It's been a bit of an eye-opener tonight. And that's basically it. Nice couple. Just drink a little bit too much.
Coming up, the Palmer's holiday proves too much for the Angel guests.
I feel like I've been landed on another planet.
And Julie pulls a stunt that pushes Bill to the limit.
OK, we're all for a laugh, but that's way out of order.
At Haven Holiday Camp in Devon, the Palmers are up early to pack in as much organised fun as possible. Dad Bill braves the British weather to wake the psychic angel guest family, who have yet to reveal their true identity.
Good morning, you old
goat.
How are you doing?
Right. We're all ready then. Go up to breakfast in half an hour at the main site. OK?
We've got our plans together.
During their dealings with the dead, the angel guests have come across many ghouls and ghosts, but they're about to experience a very different encounter as they come face to face with Rory the Tiger and the rest of his cuddly chums at a welcoming character breakfast.
Look at her little face.
It may be heaven for the Palmers, but it's the angel guests' idea of hell.
Hello, Polly. All right, sweetheart?
You're right, sweetheart.
Hands up if you've got a headache.
Hands up if you're awake.
Poor Bradley the bear becomes the butt of Julie's joke.
Christian just said the only bear he gets in the morning is my bear ass.
But Tracy's not amused by Julie's attitude to her family-focused holiday.
Because they've got no children, young like ours, it's irrelevant to them whether Amelia's face lights up when she sees the bear or the tiger or the monkey. And I'm not bothered. It's the kids I'm more concerned about.
The angel guests may have survived the furry zoo, but they must now get through a jam-packed day of wholesome fun. Yeah! Danny has never been to a holiday camp before, but he's starting to see the light.
Haven's actually the kind of place I would go on holiday. I did not expect how posh stuff was. And it's just a really great place to just go to and just chill out.
Get you six.
I got kind of psychic vibes with Amy. She's cool because we got to know each other and she's really ace.
But the endless family fun is a culture shock for Julie and Christian, who hit the bar to help get through the day.
Stress break.
With so many kids' activities to pack in, the Palmers prefer to save drinking for the evening.
You can tell the big drinkers, by the way, no disrespect to them, by the way they dress, and they're out to have a good time. Let them get on with it. They'll just have a terrible hangover. They'll miss out.
When in Rome.
The angel guests' drinking fails to relieve their stress at being away from the spirit world. But even in the fluffy heart of the holiday camp, the ghosts find a way.
A couple of times I've sensed a presence around Tracy, but I've told them to spirits to go away because it's not the time or place.
Tracy's picking up on things too.
I'm not knocking the way they dress, but tattoo, biker type. I don't know.
Well, their life would be totally different culture to ours, wouldn't it? I mean, they're bikers, and bikers tend to be a bit rough and ready. I'm not saying that they are rough and ready, but...
No, they're not rough and ready. I don't know, there's just... I don't know, there's just something. I can't put my finger on it.
Julie might not be getting far with the Palmers, but Danny is having much better luck with Amy.
Do birds suddenly appear every time you are near? Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky?
thing.
You wish, you wish. He thinks he's got me right around his little finger, but no, it's
she knows it.
If I say jump, you don't say when, you say ha ha.
With the wine flowing, Christian decides to really get the party going. Not to be outdone, Julie pulls what she feels is a classic biker stunt. But it's far more than Bill had bargained for.
What can I say? I'm a lucky man. Going home.
We did the true biker chick thing, like she got her tits out, you know. And it just had to be done really, like, you know, just to lead them straightly off the path, like, you know. And I think it rocked.
It might have rocked for Christian, but for family man Bill, it's a step too far.
That was out of order. Big time. You don't do that. Okay, they're up for a laugh, we're up for a laugh, but that's way out of order. Way, way out of order.
Bill now faces the challenge of explaining to his wife what Julie's just revealed.
Straight after you went, we had a drink, and...
What, they asked you to go back to their caravan for sex?
No.
What then?
She's got a 38DD boobs out, and... She actually stood there and licked her nipple.
In front of who?
In front of a lot of people.
Can't you tell, Bill, what type of people they are when they come out dressed like that? Don't you think about things like that?
Yeah, I do. So tomorrow, it's drinking in moderation.
After last night, it seems that the two families have very different ideas about what's acceptable behaviour.
No, I don't care. And, you know, wherever you go, there's tits left, right and centre. There's tits on the front cover of national newspapers every time you go to the newsagents.
But the Palmers have other ideas.
Good morning. Morning, campers. All right.
Yeah, all right.
Come in.
Yeah, come in.
Did you have too much to drink last night, then?
Yeah.
Too much?
Well, that's what I want to see you about, actually.
Yeah. Can't remember what you did?
No, I do remember what I did.
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, it was way out of order.
Righto.
Right. Rock concerts, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Fine. I've seen them. I've got mates that go to rock concerts.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Brilliant. Family orientated holiday. It's just not the place to be doing it, to be perfectly honest with you.
No.
And the other thing is the drinking. It was, you had it last night. You'd really had enough last night, both of you.
We don't drink at all, so, because on your holiday, you drink.
I've already got five children. I don't want to have two more to look after.
No, I will not.
I don't want any more children.
And I've said it all along, I will not tell you what to do.
Fair enough, innit? We'll behave ourselves on that kind of front.
Although the Palmers appear to have forgiven the angel guests, Julie's only too aware that they might find it harder to forget.
I think I completely respect what they've said, but I'm genuinely upset that they're upset.
I think it's funny what she did. So she's got confidence and big boobs.
Amy is keen to keep Christian and Julie on side to help win Danny back after her illicit dance last night.
And then we had a row.
Even Danny had a row.
Yeah. It's like we're together. It's like, I can't do nothing. Is that you got jealous because I was dancing with someone.
Young lover.
Kissed him yesterday.
Ooh. Was it peck or tongues and everything?
It's like a little peck.
Got a gentleman, doesn't he?
Yeah, he is such a gentleman, yeah.
In a last-ditch attempt to save their flagging romance, Amy goes in search of a peace offering.
I'm one of them people who likes to make up and don't have an argument or don't hold grudges. So brought him this to say sorry. And hopefully he'll wear it and hopefully he'll say, yes, this is my necklace that my best ever friend brought me off holiday.
The angel guests' attempt to fit in is backfiring and the families decide to spend some time apart. To escape the escalating tension, Tracy and Amy decide they need some pampering.
Haven isn't about stress. It's about de-stress. I mean, look at me, five children, they're all sorted.
For Julie and Christian, De-stressing means getting as far away from the camp as possible. Shutting out the psychic world is proving harder than they thought.
We've been in an environment where we've been so grounded around other people and so much going on that it's not a geographical homesickness, it's more of a spiritual homesickness.
I feel like I've been landed on another planet.
Yeah.
This is like normal. This is what most normal people do. And that is, I think that's made me feel really quite depressed. It's an awful thing to say, isn't it?
Despite their differences, the families decide to spend some time together. Whilst Julie tries to bury her troubles, Christian still seems uncomfortable.
Chris seems like a fish out of water, doesn't he, where kids are. He's not really got involved with Amelia or Alice doing Sandcastles Road. You know, I mean, I knew within like 15, 20 minutes I'd get on with him. But you can't get the measure of somebody in 4 days, can you?
The tensions between the adults has filtered down to Amy and Danny.
She doesn't think I like the necklace that she brought me.
No, I don't care. I don't care if you like it, as long as I brought it, that's what I'm bothered about. No, I just don't get you at all.
If you knew me, you'd hate me.
It's the last night of the Palmer's stay in Haven. Tomorrow, the angel guests will reveal their spooky identity and scary holiday.
Very apprehensive. Very apprehensive.
It could be anything, going clubbing every night or...
Let's just say it's a music concert, so it's music 24/7.
Well, I'm not going.
I won't go.
Get a headache.
I think the kids will be up for it.
Yeah.
Most children are naturally psychic. Most children have these so-called imaginary friends that aren't imaginary after all. And a lot of kids are into Harry Potter. But I think the main thing is going to be convincing Bill and Tracy that their kids are safe.
But Bill's main worry is what Julie might reveal next.
The first time she strips or gets her boobs out or gets pissed, we're out of here. And I will personally pack the suitcases and I'm gone.
Coming up, the ghosts are out.
Bench pendulum's going around like mad. It's probably the most haunted place I've ever stepped foot in.
And so are the knives.
I don't really want Tracy in my aura. I don't want that woman anywhere around me at this precise moment in time.
The psychic angel guests have endured almost a week in a Devon holiday camp. But now it's time for their holiday, a mystical tour of the UK's most haunted places. Back in their familiar ghost-busting gear and with crystals at the ready, they do a last-minute psychic protection spell. Christian and Julie have arranged a ghost-busting bus for their spooky tour. The Palmers are still in the dark and under the impression that their hosts are bikers.
Meet us at the Beachcomber car park and all will be revealed. The angel guests, be happy. It's probably one of them big American yellow buses.
Oh, okay, no. It's absolutely
motorbikes. Climbing.
Oh, no, not motorbikes.
Quad bikes.
Oh, my...
No.
Come on. Oh, my,
oh,
God.
My God.
What's
oh,
this?
Oh, my God.
Oh, I reckon the rock stars
are
going like a
tower. Oh,
I reckon we've been stitched up big time, haven't we? Who are these people? What's that on that?
Ghosts.
Ghosts.
Yeah, look.
Oh, yeah. I've, yes, it's a joke.
I told you.
Hold on a second. I'll soon explain.
dear me.
Well, Palmer Army, we've really enjoyed your holiday and we'd really like it if you come and join us on a bit of ghost hunting and psychic development. You can take a vote on that, whether you want to take part. You'll be completely safe.
Yeah, we'll, yeah.
Yay! Excellent. Palmer Army, I've got marching on.
Well, I'm not wearing anything like that.
That's all right, you haven't got to worry about that.
Good.
That is going to be fun.
meditating.
Crap.
Dick, how do you know it's crap? You don't have been yet.
I don't want to go that.
So where are we sleeping?
In a haunted house, probably. I'm up for that, it'd be a laugh, wouldn't it? What bumps in the night, we're not bothered about.
Yeah, you don't like that stuff.
I don't believe in it. I don't believe in ghosts and all that crap.
Are you going to take the piss?
Yeah, I will do, yeah.
I don't think he's a sceptic. I think he's scared. I think Bill is actually genuinely scared.
And I can't wait for Amy to find out that Dan is a reverend. She's been snogging a man of the cloth.
I ain't going to kiss her on this holiday, because, like, I'll just say, concentration.
For Amy, Danny's eerie secret is a major turn-off.
My opinion of Danny now has totally changed. He's different. He's not talking to me like he normally does. He's not being nice and gentlemanly like. He's just avoiding me and not talking to me, so stuff him.
I've always said that I would sleep in the most haunted house in Britain, no problem.
They wouldn't.
I bet you I wouldn't.
They wouldn't.
Put the money where your mouth is, eh?
The families are to spend the next week exploring haunted locations all over the UK. Bill doesn't know it yet, but the final challenge of the tour is to spend a night in Britain's most haunted castle.
OK, Palmer Army, I'm glad you decided to come and join us on our ghost hunting and psychic development tour. This is going to be the best 4 days of your lives. The rules of our holiday are as follows. First of all, please use the psychic protection that we give you. We do believe in the existence of ghosts, spirits, orbs, elementals and negative entities. We're not here to preach about our beliefs, nor to convert you in any way, but we do ask you to respect ghosts and spirits because they do have feelings too. So have a nice holiday, otherwise we'll hex you all.
Oh, there's an orb. We're chasing it.
The first stop on the tour is Hairy Hands Forest in Dartmoor. According to Julie, the woods are teeming with lots of little fairies.
I want you to dance around the fairy circles and everything, all right?
Take all your clothes off and run around the woods.
We've got nothing coming, haven't we?
Well, you and Danny could have done it if you wanted to.
No,
Danny doesn't like me anymore. He's avoiding me, he's not expecting me all day.
Julie hopes the forest visit will break the Palmers in gently to the spirit world. To find the fairies, the families will of course need wands, which can be made from sticks.
If there's a twig on the tree itself, you have to ask the tree first if it's okay for you to have it. 99 times out of 100, you'll get drawn to the twig that you're meant to have.
You might have to hug a few before you find the right
Alice,
one. All right.
Yeah, hug the tree before you find the right one.
Hug a few.
I don't like that one. Oh, I like this one. What the hell am I doing?
As Alice is finding out, some of the best wands require the most work.
Please, can I have a brunch? Yay! I said my money's in a game with me.
While some of the Palmers are away with the fairies, Amy's having trouble crossing over to the other side.
I don't believe any of this. It's so load of crap, isn't it? It goes around hugging trees. No one goes around hugging trees.
Around the base of the tree, I'm seeing little... They are fairies. They're like... Just to describe what I'm seeing, it's like... If in your mind's eye, you can see, like, angel wings, little fairy wings, and little glimmers of light.
Am I going to see fairy and goblins?
No, try.
I think I'm going to cry.
Julie has years of experience seeing fairies, but it takes a real skill, a potential she spots in 12-year-old Corey.
It takes a while to see them, because I do this all day, every day. Be like me trying to play football with you straight away and picking up straight away. You'd have to teach me how to do it, because it takes practice.
I don't know if I believe in fairies, because I couldn't see them at the start, but then I think it was flies or something. It's got to be something. So I don't know what it was. Some flies or fairies.
Despite befriending the trees, Bill has yet to see a fairy.
At the end of the day, if this is what you believe in, that's
I know, and I'm not. We're not here to, like I said a thousand million times. I'll say it again. Not here to convert. I just want them to have some fun. And this is the weirdest.
I just enjoy being here.
Yeah, that's just enjoy the nature.
Peace and quiet.
Yeah, away from the noise and humdrum of everyday life.
Armed with their wands, the families continue on their spiritual mystery tour. Next stop is 300-year-old Bodmin Jail in Cornwall. It's one of the most haunted buildings in Britain. Christian is even picking up vibes at the local hotel.
Well, we're here in Bodmin. I've had quite a negative presence there. When we first came into Bodmin, something quite negative, which is always a good sign.
But the negativity isn't limited to the spirit world. Amy and Danny's relationship is now beyond repair.
She just won't get off my back. She's just all like, oh, come outside, every 5 seconds.
When it was my holiday, he was fine and talking to me. And now that it's his holiday, he's not said one word to me. And then he just used me for a kiss and that was it. With a slime ball.
I'm actually trying to focus on something else I don't need on, like, my holiday. A girl just trying to pull me away from something I love.
With so many spirits at large, Julie feels it necessary to equip the Palmers with essential psychic protection.
We've got some clothes for you if you want to wear them.
You know,
we've got two skirts for Amy and Tracy. That's if you want to wear these. The reason they're black is because black's a protective colour.
Quite a lot.
Bill's vamping it up.
Give me your vein. I want your vein.
And Tracy can't take the wands and capes seriously.
What they're trying to do, they're spiritualist people, but they're dressing like goths and they're just giving the wrong impression.
I think she's probably tired and she wants to go home.
Yeah, I think, I knew that. I knew that from the outset. But that's their problem, not mine.
Bodmin Jail, once the site of public hangings, is now home to hundreds of headless ghosts, poltergeists and apparitions. It's become a major tourist attraction, regularly visited by families and coachloads of bloodthirsty schoolchildren. The families face a ghoulish evening tour through the cells and torture chambers, all haunted by the tormented souls of dead prisoners. But first, the Palmers stop for a cheese quiche. The angel guests are already picking up high levels of paranormal activity and decide to check out what lies ahead.
This is grim. There's been some suffering going on in here.
I get the feeling not of they're waiting for the death.
No, I'm not scared. I'm not bothered.
I'm not scared because I don't believe in it. So what's the point of being scared because you don't believe in it?
I'm like that. Yeah. I'm not scared. I'm more waiting for the laughs and even more going to have.
Are you worried?
Are you worried?
A bit.
The bench pendulum's going round like mad, which is indicating the presence of spirit. It's going in a clockwise direction. We've got spirits that are trapped here that don't want to be here. They haven't crossed over. It's probably the most haunted place I've ever stepped foot in, I have to say.
It's all a long way from the family entertainment of the Palmer's holiday, and it's starting to trouble Bill.
I'm very worried at the minute about downstairs. Apparently it's quite scary, so I'm going to go down and check it out. If I don't think it's suitable for the kids, then they won't be doing it.
Bill spots some ghastly sights, but they're not from the spirit world.
When I've not seen one, not one dummy, and that's what they are, that look remotely realistic. I mean, what's that there? That just looks, be honest with you, that looks like a dry bogey in the corner of a wall. No, it does, don't it? I mean, what is it?
Yeah, well, we weren't looking at the models.
See, what we
No, this is exactly what I'm saying. You're seeing it from a different perspective,
if
aren't
you'd
you?
Seen...
I'll be honest with you, what I've seen up to now, my kids will probably take the piss out of it.
Yeah.
Great.
You're talking to a disbeliever, I'm a total disbeliever. And that sort of stuff. It's just made me dig my heels in a bit more.
I respect Bill's beliefs and all that, but, you know, I think he just thinks Julie's a joke.
Convinced that the jail is populated by nothing more than a selection of stuffed models, Bill is happy to let his family look around.
Is that it? So it took 3 hours to just look around here?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
They don't even look realistic, do they?
No, it's too small.
I'm OK here. It's not my ideal of a holiday, really.
Alice is OK, but her sister Amelia looks like she's seen a ghost.
Amelia, look around. Amelia, look.
Amelia, it's a brick wall.
It's a brick wall, Amelia. I can't be scared.
It's not right taking a 7-year-old kid down here at 12 o'clock at night. Julie wants to carry on scaring my sister, then let her. I'll just tell her what for.
Amelia's fright is the last straw for a furious Tracy, who brings an immediate stop to the tour. Holding Julie responsible, she hits back where it hurts.
No motherly instincts at all.
Of course I have.
This is what I do for a profession. You're telling me how to do my job.
No, I'm not telling you how to do your job. But I'm a mum. You're not a mum, Julie. I'm a mum.
I'm a mother.
A stepmother of Emily.
I haven't given birth to a child. It doesn't mean I haven't got a maternal instinct.
Right.
Well, she's got to take on board there's children involved. Now, if she made it all nice and not scary and relaxed, I mean, if she wants a reaction from me, she'll get a reaction from me.
Back at the hotel, Julie is outraged.
I don't really want Tracy in my aura. I don't want that woman anywhere around me at this precise moment in time, as much as I've got on with her. Whereas I respect her as a mother, and I respect her beliefs. They don't respect mine. I don't want to share my holiday with her.
Coming up, the gloves are off.
You're making it worse than it is for the children. You
I'm
want
not.
To
it's a tourist attraction.
You brought them on this holiday.
And Julie's reached her limit.
I'm all hyped up on emotions, and I'd rather just go.
It's the second morning of the Angel Guests ghost-busting holiday, and the families are no longer on speaking terms. Upset by Bill's attitude and Tracy's personal remarks last night, the Angel Guests are questioning whether to continue. They call a meeting to confront the Palmers.
Tracy, the thing that hurt me last night is you said about the lack of maternal skills, criticising me in front of Emily and Danny. When you said, have I got no maternal skills, did you not think...
No, not maternal skills. The feelings. Not a skill. A skill comes.
Yeah.
Any child of 6 or 7, I don't care who they are, whether it's David Beckham or anybody, they wouldn't put their children through spooky, ghosty, scary things.
Well, it's a tourist attraction.
You brought them on this holiday. So
you signed up.
You brought us on this holiday.
You didn't come along. You knew what we were doing on the day, on the first day.
I mean, our holiday, it speaks for itself, doesn't it? Fun. Yeah.
Well, for you, yeah.
Right.
Now, you're contradicting yourself because yesterday you turned round and said you'd had a brilliant time, everything that we'd done, you'd enjoyed it. Now you're saying the opposite. Well, which one is it?
Right, OK, I've had fun with your family, yeah? The karaoke and the cabaret, that's not my thing, I've been honest about that all the way.
No, but yesterday you said you enjoyed
we did.
Now you're saying that you didn't.
No, no, there are aspects I've enjoyed of it and some of them I didn't.
Under attack, the Palmers shift the focus of the meeting to Julie's behaviour on their holiday.
I don't know how critical you are as a person, but I take things in my stride. We went to the forest yesterday and it was fairies and it was fantastic with the wands and the wishes for the kids. It was lovely, the environment was lovely. And Alice said to me, I can't understand why Julie did what she did Tuesday, then look at her now. You know, you put yourself across as two different people.
Because
you know,
I felt like a fish out of water on your holiday.
Yeah, but you don't do things like that,
Julie,
do you? You don't get your
I feel like
a
fish out of water on it.
No, is that a character? We apologise for it.
We wouldn't do that. And if I would never go into a family complex wearing a PVC cat suit and get my boobs out.
Right, you know, from now, from today.
Hang on, Julie. You've
been talking for a while. From today, Monday, Tuesday, I don't want to hear it again. It's gone, it's dead, it's buried, right? It's finished.
Sorted then. Come on then, get a move on.
Tracy may feel it's all sorted, but throwing all the criticism back on Julie is the final insult for the Angel Guests.
How do you feel about the other family?
I'm starting to get really egged off about them now.
As the families prepare to leave the hotel, Bill senses that all is not well.
Something's cracking off. I don't know what's cracking off, but I thought we'd cleared the air. And they don't look happy. I don't know what's happening.
Upset by the meeting and with resentment growing, the angel guests are unable to continue.
I'm just going to go now. Some of the comments made to me were at a very personal level. When I feel I'm under attack and it makes me feel negative, it makes it harder for me to do spiritual work. This is what I do for a living. This is what I believe in. I'm not asking them to believe in what I believe in, but a bit of respect wouldn't have gone amiss. At the moment, I'm all hyped up on emotions and I'd rather just go.
Although the angel guests are leaving, the Palmers decide to see the holiday through to the end and to determine once and for all if there really is anything out there.
I never thought that it would end up with the angels leaving on their holiday. I'm not gloating, I'm not saying, yeah, we're still here. I'm not saying that.
Right then, guys. Unfortunately, the angels have flew the nest. So the Palmer family are taking over. Tonight we're going to spend the night in a spooky castle. Right, I don't believe in ghosts or spooks, but we'll see if we can find some.
The final stop on the ghost tour is 1,000-year-old Chillingham Castle in Northumbria. Chillingham is considered to be the most haunted castle in the UK. It has 25 resident spirits, the oldest of which is an 800-year-old ghost who goes by the name of Mary. The Palmers will be staying in the oldest part of the castle, where visitors have frequently reported paranormal activity.
Very nice, I like it.
I'll take it.
Without the angel guests to guide them, the Palmer adults take a tour of the castle with local psychic Belinda Bray.
In here, there is a lady who sits at the pianoforte.
Yeah.
Where's the piano? And she's got a blue dress on.
Yeah.
And tinkling away at the ivories.
Is she over there now?
Yes.
Would she mind me trying to touch on her?
No.
Although Belinda's surrounded by ghosts, Bill's not getting anything.
I'm not just being disrespectful to the lady. She's obviously dangerous stuff, but I'm just not feeling anything at all.
I'm not either, not one bit.
No.
Can you feel a warmth?
No.
Nothing?
Absolutely nothing.
No? He's dead? He must be dead.
But as Amy enters the banqueting hall, her scepticism begins to give way.
Is there one in this room now?
Do you feel extremely cold?
My legs are cold.
Well, perhaps you've got the little girl. There's a little girl wanders round.
Is she by Amy now?
There is a little girl there, kneeling by her, yes.
I'm gonna cry. Come here, Adam.
She's getting up now. She's getting up and just looking at you.
Because it sounds like she's... I'm not joking, my face is cold. It sounds like she's took a shine to Amy.
The tour might be over, but the biggest challenge still awaits Bill. To spend a whole night in the most haunted room in Britain's most haunted castle. It's been a long night, but has it been enough to convert skeptic Bill into a true believer?
Who's the man? I did hear a few bumps and bangs and a funny rustling, which I thought was curtains. Spoke to Tracy this morning and she said, was it like some sort of material that they have on dresses like? Well, it could have been dragging across the floor. Yeah, maybe there is something there. Maybe there is, but I mean, it didn't spook me. It didn't scare me at all. I wasn't scared at all, you know what I mean? But maybe there is something to it.
Before leaving Chillingham, the Palmers reflect on their experiences.
If ghost hunting rocks your boat, then fine, you go ahead with it. You go ahead with it. But for my family, no.
Safely at home, the angel guests have their own views on the holidays.
I don't feel that the Palmers can really criticise our holiday because the opportunity was there for spiritual growth, development, paranormal investigation, but they chose not to experience it.
Kids
on holiday should be kids, whether it's a haven holiday, whether it is a ghost hunting holiday. And Julie's idea was shock, horror, scare.
Yes, the psychic and spiritual dimension of life is a bit different, but I would never put a child in a situation that I think is unsuitable.
I think they just did enjoy the Haven holiday, but I didn't think they wanted to show it too much.
If I was a kid and that had been my parents' concept of a holiday, I would have been bored out of my bloody brain.
The positive thing I got from Haven is that in the future, if I thought about going there, I know not to bother now.
Hello, Angel Cash. Palmer Home here.
Hello, the Palmer family.
We'd just like to say that we loved our holiday, but unfortunately didn't like yours.
Bill, thanks for taking part in our holiday. Your sense of humour really raised the vibrations.
I really enjoyed Chillingham Castle and you missed out. You missed out big time.
We heard that you've had a few experiences and that your mind's more open to the spiritual world. We wish we could have been there to help you develop further.
Ooh, you've converted us, look.
Next, the Night TV One, Tarentan TV, and plenty of examples why British TV isn't that bad after all, especially when you look at the dogs in entertaining guises and the frank advice from Canada. On ITV2, Adam Sandler stars in tonight's movie Bulletproof, and there's drama in Chancer on ITV3 next.